The United States is probably the most vulnerable country in the world, right? We live in a glass house.
Today's exercise provides us with the opportunity to see how a national level cyber attack might be handled and to identify both our strengths and what gaps might exist.
Iran has attacked our critical infrastructure. We have people dead in Los Angeles. We got to do something as the federal government.
We don't have a cyber problem. We've got an Iran problem, and that fits in with all of the other Iran problems that we have, like with nuclear weapons. And so once it gets past kind of a certain threshold, it's not just a cyber incident anymore. It's fitting in with these other pathways that the government has in place.
We do need to, at every step, anticipate and mitigate to the greatest degree possible the potential impact on private sector entities, because Iran has shown very clearly their inclination to attack non-governmental targets. And so we need to be working with them, and we need to be prepared for that.
We've now been through 10 years of cyber attacks, is to think about cyber attacks with cyber solutions.
So attribution is really a key part of threat response.
Well, I mean, we just can't sit back until we have perfect evidence.
This has been a very sort of emotional topic of conversation at very senior levels in the government, whether it's around potential terrorist attack or cyber attacks. When and how much do you tell the public?
Because how you message this to the American people, to the state and local government, to the private sector, and to our allies around the world is now, I think, critical to our response.
And balancing creating unnecessary fear versus giving people information that they need to make a risk-based decision for themselves.
There's a lot that's within the control of the federal government, but when it comes to attacks through cyber, there's a lot that is not. And that includes both that is in the hands of state and local authorities and what's going to be in the hands of the private sector.
Private sector is very relevant here, not just as potential victims, but as potential folks who can contribute to the solution set. And that's a lot of the people who are here at this conference.